Layers are one of the most sought-after tools included in many photo editing programs, and a lot of the times you have to have a paid program in order to be able to work with layers. Paint.net is free, but it also allows you to work with layers, which is a nice added bonus to it. Using layers has a lot of different advantages over making adjustments directly to the original image. You can do temporary edits. It will help you to avoid data loss. It'll let you do specific point editing. There's a lot of different advantages to using layers. And any advanced photo editor uses layers, and it saves you a lot of time. So I'm going to explain layers to you in this video. The image that you're looking at right now is what a viewer would see straight on whenever they looked at it on a website or printed on a page or whatever. But to explain layers to you, if you could see the layers or see the image on a side view, this is what the image would look like when you see all the layers attached to it. You'll see that that initial image is really made up of four different layers. You have your background, your two clouds, and then a title screen on top. So we're going to try to recreate this just a little bit so I can show you how to work with layers. We're going to create a new image, and I'm going to come and pick a blue. I'm going to add a background color to this. Now I'm going to come and open up a cloud image. And you'll notice anytime you open your images, all of your displayed or open images within Paint.net are listed up here at the top. So I have my cloud image. I'm going to use my selection tool, and I'm going to come up and copy it. I'm going to come over to this blue background, and I'm going to go and paste it. You'll notice that you have three options in pasting. Your first one is going to paste it directly on that blue background, or you can paste it into a new layer, or you can paste it into a brand new image. For this, we want to paste it into a new layer. And you're going to notice over here in your layers palette, it should have added a second layer that shows your image of your cloud. Now, this is the benefit of layers. You can move this cloud around as much as you want, and it never really alters this background image of it. Down here in your layers palette, you have a lot of other options here as well. You can add a new layer if you wanted. So from there, I could click on that, add a new layer. If I wanted to come in here and type some text, I'm going to select white. You can put that directly anywhere you want to without moving your cloud. Your second option is your delete button. So if you decide that you don't want that text, you can come here and delete it. You also have a duplicate layer. So if I wanted to make more clouds, I could come back to this initial cloud image, copy it, come back here and paste it again, or I could use my duplicate layer options. All you have to do is make sure you're on the appropriate layer that you want duplicated. And I say that because a lot of times I'll be on the wrong layer and go to duplicate, and I'm making duplicates of something that I don't want to. So make sure you're on the correct layer. You can click duplicate. You'll see that it shows over here. It doesn't really show you much on the screen because they're sitting on top of each other. But from here I can move those clouds around. You also have your merge layer down button, and this is going to merge these top two layers. So currently, I can move this cloud separately among themselves. But if I get it, the clouds right where I want them to be, and I want to merge those layers, so anytime I move one, it moves the other, that's when you would use this merge layer down button. That's going to merge them both together. So now they're seen as one layer together and not two separate layers. And then you have your move up and move down. So to show that, I'm going to come and open up a rainbow. Select my rainbow, and I'm going to copy it. I'm going to come back to this initial image. And again, I'm going to paste it into a new layer. A lot of times if you're pasting something that's larger, it's going to ask you, do you want to expand your canvas to accommodate the new layer, or do you want to keep your current canvas size? So for this example, I'm going to keep the canvas size. And now you'll see anytime I move this around, my rainbow, it's kind of a little bit hard to tell because my rainbow is a little bit opaque, but my rainbow is on top of the clouds. If ever I wanted to move my rainbow below the clouds, I could come down here and move the layer down, and it would put it behind it. I could even do that with the background. I can move my background up, and now my blue is on top of my rainbow, which means you can't see it. So that's how you would move your layers around. You also have the option to hide your layers. Over here to the right of each layer is a check mark box. And if you remove the check mark in that box, it's going to remove that layer. And now, anytime you save this image with a layer hidden, it's going to save the image exactly as it looks. So if I go to click save, it's going to save it just as the background with the rainbow. I can show the clouds, go save again, and it's going to save it with the clouds in there. Another handy tip if you're going to be using a lot of different logos or whatever. If you want to try this same image with our F logo and then with our paw print logo without having to recreate it a lot of different times, all you'd have to do really is hide the layer of them. So that's your explanation of layers. If you're working within Paint and you can't find your layers palette, all you need to do is come up here to your Windows menu and make sure that your layers palette is selected, and that will either hide it or it will make it visible again.